We have Daniel Prusilides, who just walked out of walkout. He's standing by for us in the foyer of the House of Commons in Ottawa. So we're going to go straight to Daniel Prusilides right now. Daniel, we're looking over your notes here. You've been in lockup. Why don't you take us through it all?
Sure. Well, I mean, the government gave the obvious announcements that we've just already been talking about, the Nexen deal, takeover by Chinese-owned CNOOC. That has been approved, as has the deal by Petronas, Malaysian-owned Petronas, to take over Progress Energy. So two major deals in the Canadian energy sector have been approved. What's also interesting, however, is that the government has introduced new rules for state-owned enterprises. That is to say, government-owned companies that try to buy their way into Canada. When it comes to the oil sands, they're introducing special protections for the oil sands, and the new rules state essentially that those kinds of deals in future will only be approved in exceptional circumstances. That's a key change. Other changes that have now been made, or are going to be made, I should say more precisely, include toughening up the rules for state-owned enterprises in general trying to take over Canadian companies. So now the industry minister, when those reviews take place, will also be looking at the extent to which a foreign government controls or has influence over the state-owned enterprise buying its way into Canada, and how much influence that state-owned enterprise will then have over the Canadian company or over the industry in general that it's buying into. Also, they're raising the threshold for private foreign companies that are buying into Canada. That is to say, government reviews of foreign investments in Canada will only kick in at the billion-dollar level when it comes to private companies. However, when it comes to state-owned enterprises, the threshold remains $333 million. And the other key change is around national security. Right now, the industry minister can do national security reviews of foreign takeovers of Canadian companies, and the new rules allow the minister to also seek an extension if those national security reviews are taking a long time or are very complex.
It's going to be an obvious question, but I'm going to ask it anyway for viewers who are watching us, Daniel, across the country. Why such strict guidelines when it comes to Canada's oil sands?
That's a good question, and the Prime Minister is expected to address that just minutes from now, but in the indications that we have, just from looking at his prepared remarks, are that as far as the oil sands go, the level of foreign investment right now in the oil sands, presumably with these two takeovers that have been approved, is at a level that the government says is high enough, and they don't want to see it really go higher. And they're also saying that, you know, Canadians have spent years trying to reduce government control of key government of key industries in Canada. They don't want to see that those industries then go into the control of foreign governments if Canadian governments have already divested their interest.
Any sense, Daniel, why it took so long to get to this point? There were so many delays to get to the actual final decision by the Harper government.
Well, we can only guess. The government hasn't really spoken about that yet, except to say that these are complex deals, that they're obviously very big deals and very valuable and very important to a lot of investors in Canada, not to mention around the world. So there are some complex issues here, and they do involve government-owned foreign companies owned by foreign governments. And so that also presents some interesting challenges for the industry minister in approving or disapproving these deals. Obviously, they were approved in these two cases.
And I guess the rewriting of the playbook, so to speak, when it comes to takeovers by foreign companies, foreign organizations, is it because we're dealing with China, or is it because, I guess, it's a state-owned company that the rules needed to be, I guess, sort of set in stone for future deals and takeovers?
They don't get too specific whether it's China or some other country. What they do say, however, is that state-owned enterprises deserve special protection, rather special treatment, because they are owned by foreign governments, because they don't necessarily play by market rules, and because very often they are an instrument of foreign policy for foreign governments. And that's been one of the fears when it comes to CNOOC, for example.
One last question for you on the issue of reciprocity. Anything in there in terms of whether there would be a level playing field should Canadians want to buy into China? Mentioned about that?
It's a good question. Zero so far.
Okay, so we'll learn more in a couple minutes. Daniel, really appreciate that. Thank you.
Anytime. Okay.